The PlayStation 5 may be out in the wilds right now, but not everyone can get it yet. Let's take a look back and celebrate the 25 best PlayStation 4 titles in this early 2021 update, all arranged by PlayScore. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. If you want to become part of our growing community, we have a Patreon page. Check it out. Link in the description box below. Number 25. A PlayStation 2 gem remastered for the PlayStation 4, Shadow of the Colossus' gorgeous world is polished to near perfection by Bluepoint Studios, the same people who developed the remake for Demon's Souls. Never have we felt this bad for slaughtering these creatures. A play score of 8.96. Number 24, Diablo 3 Ultimate Edition. The PlayStation 4 was also an unlikely home for Blizzard's RPG. Ultimate Edition gave us the definitive Diablo 3 experience, including the DLCs and much-needed visual upgrade. It's a well-made port praised for its seamless UI and multiplayer modes. It's one of those few PC titles that surprisingly work well on the console, and it receives a play score of 8.98. Number 23, Inside. Just slightly ahead with the same play score rating is Playdead's Eerie Platformer. After Limbo's massive success, their latest installment takes us into a dystopia riddled with questions. Just, what are we doing here? Where are we headed? It's no horror game, but it does bring out some unsettling moments. Number 22, Fallout 4. Bethesda's award-winning RPG focused all its storytelling efforts into this fourth mainline entry of the series. It was generally praised for its fun role-playing elements, its open world, and most of all, its limitless modding potential. For many Fallout fans, this was the series' last decent entry, a play score of 9.0. Number 21, Batman Arkham Knight. The last Batman game from Rocksteady finally gave us what we needed, the Batmobile. While it did overstay its welcome in a gameplay sense, it was a breath of fresh air to use this armored tank to topple down Gotham's scum. It's the strongest Arkham to date in terms of open world and combat, and it earns a play score of 9.02. Did you know? Your reviews can influence our play score. Tune in to our website at whattoplay.com and leave a review for your favorite games. Number 20, Devil May Cry 5. The fifth mainline DMC entry continues the tradition of killing demons with style. Capcom's character action series returns to its original form, and it brings together the series' top dogs. It also brings out the best of the characters' personalities with its complex gameplay and energetic soundtrack. Its final paid DLC adds the motivated Virgil with his own weapons and playstyle. A play score of 9.07. Number 19, Monster Hunter World. Before we get our hands on their latest project, Monster Hunter Rise, we'll look back to the game that breathed new life to the series. World is the biggest MH game to date. It's loaded with huge maps to explore and ferocious beasts to slay with your friends. Not only that, their latest DLC, Iceborne, also brought a ton of new content to the already jam-packed base game. It receives a play score of 9.08. Number 18. Shovel Knight is a treasure trove of platforming goodness, reminiscent of the good old days of the genre. Making our way around these hallowed halls, armed with only a shovel, is both challenging and downright frustrating at times. All this effort in the name of love. A play score of 9.09. Number 17, Dark Souls 3. Speaking of challenges and frustrations, nothing beats Dark Souls' intentional difficulty spikes. 3 was the series' last hurrah before creator Hidetaka Miyazaki put his focus on his most anticipated title, Elden Ring. It's the final Dark Souls game of the series, and it ended on a high note. It's still absurdly hard, but if you made it through 1 and 2, then 3 will be a rewarding experience. a play score of 9.10. Number 16. A recent addition to our list, Sucker Punch made us feel like the ultimate samurai badass with Ghost of Tsushima. Taking down Mongols or raiding bandits using a ballet of sword attacks is as satisfying as taking a minute to pause and appreciate the gorgeous landscapes of the island. A play score of 9.10. Number 15. Marvel Spider-Man, Miles Morales. His exaggerated swagger might be the reason Insomniac gave us his own standalone story. Kidding aside, Miles Morales is a fantastic superhero follow-up to the already successful original. This short but emotional experience gave us a character study of the heroic Greenhorn as he makes peace with his responsibilities and prepares himself for an inevitable sequel. A play score of 9.11. Number 14, Horizon Zero Dawn. Aloy is just getting started in this first Horizon entry. Zero Dawn's ambitious open-world adventure takes us into unforgiving lands teeming with mechanical wildlife and science fiction mystery. Her next chapter, Forbidden West, will take us further into its desolate world, and maybe we'll get more answers once it comes out soon. Zero Dawn gets a play score of 9.12. Number 13, Final Fantasy Remake. This is the first in a planned series of remakes, and it covers most of the Final Fantasy VII stories. VII Remake is a big leap for the most popular Final Fantasy title around. With Cloud and his eco-terrorist buddies, go on an adventure that could alter the fate of the franchise. This remake is its own game, and it's shaping up to be Tetsuya Nomura's most ambitious project to date. A play score of 9.12. Number 12, Bloodborne. Eldritch Terrors are just a few of the things you should be worried about in this other award-winning action RPG from Software. It's a big change in direction from its Dark Souls counterpart.
Bloodborne retains the Souls-like mechanics with an added complexity that encourages players to be as aggressive as possible in its decrepit gothic world.
It receives a play score of 9.17. Number 11, Undertale. An unlikely RPG that gained a massive internet following, Undertale has gained universal acclaim for turning the usually violent role-playing genre on its head. It adds talking as a weapon, not for killing, but for compromise. This unique experience, coupled with a cast of lovable characters, makes Toby Fox's project a welcome addition to the indie realm. A play score of 9.22. Number 10, Journey. Combining artistic imagery and simple gameplay, Journey is a wholesome video game experiment. It's a game that commits to the silence, partnering you up with the people online to serve as companions in the pilgrimage. Communicate through musical chimes, and work together to unravel a collection of rewarding puzzles and key story moments. A play score of 9.22. Number 9, Grand Theft Auto 5. It seems like Rockstar is giving us enough time to prepare us for their elusive GTA 6. 5 is still alive and kicking, all thanks to its active online mode. Everyone is always around and messing up the game's open world, whether it's by doing heists or just blowing things up. 5 is a hotbed of chaos and fun, and it receives a play score of 9.24. Number 8, Metal Gear Solid 5, Phantom Pain. Hideo Kojima's last Metal Gear game before he got booted out of the Konami offices is the series' most controversial yet. Some would say it's the perfect send-off to Snake's story, others would say it's missing key story moments. One thing's for certain, critic or fan, its open-world emergent gameplay, where being creative is more fun than being conventional, is worth checking out. A play score of 9.25. Number 7, Resident Evil 2 Remake. We return to the quaint little town of Raccoon City in this polished remake of the classic survival horror. More than just a visual upgrade and a new third-person camera, it also fleshes out both Claire and Leon's campaign, bringing surprises for new and old fans of the series. For that, it receives a play score of 9.27. Number 6, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. CDPR's open-world RPG wasn't as rocky as Cyberpunk 2077's launch. It was praised for impressive story, characters, and world-building. Geralt's journey was a memorable one, whether or not he actually managed to finish both the game and the DLC. Who knows what else lies in store for the White Wolf? A play score of 9.29.
They'll probably hang you, buddy.
You coming, buddy?
Number 5, Red Dead Redemption 2. Rockstar's gold standard of open-world gaming. According to many, RDR2 is their proudest achievement yet, and Arthur Morgan's story will sure live on in the years to come. Rockstar's narrative direction brought life to a world moving away from lawless violence. Its fascinating cast of characters, whom you've grown to hate and love, complements its living open world. It gets a play score of 9.31.
We were meant for this, Nathan. You, me, together. We were destined for something great.
Number 4, Uncharted 4, A Thief's End. Nathan Drake's final journey in the globetrotting action-adventure series from Naughty Dog. A Thief's End signifies the series' explosive crescendo with breathtaking visuals and insane set pieces. Despite its linear gameplay, the game makes up for it with its cast of interesting characters and seamless moment-to-moment action. A play score of 9.38. Number 3, The Last of Us Remastered. The least controversial entry of the two games, this remastered version brings upscaled visuals and improved frame rates to Joel and Ellie's quest for redemption in a shattered world. Not only that, the addition of the Left Behind DLC brings more focus to Ellie's growing character. A play score of 9.41.
Ready yourself.
Number 2, God of War. A soft reboot of Sony's critically acclaimed action-adventure, journey through the Nine Realms with your son Atreus, and wreak havoc in the realm of the Norse gods. Still rocking the visceral hack-and-slash combat, God of War continues to redefine its cinematic action roots. We can't wait for Ragnarok. God of War gets a play score of 9.53.
Time to fight. Are you ready?
And at number 1, Persona 5 Royal. We saw this coming. Time and time again, Atlus's JRPG proves that it's the best PlayStation 4 game. Well, according to our gamer and critic ratings. Royal is the perfect way to enjoy the Persona 5 experience, introducing a new character, a whole new story arc, and more jazzy tunes to pump up your journey. It rocketed Persona 5 back to the top spot on the PS4 with a play score of 9.59. Before we end our video, we thank these What the Players for supporting our channel through Patreon. For just $1, you can have your name plastered on our video and get exclusive What the Player rewards. Become a certified What the Player and visit our Patreon page. Link below.